under IAS 40, we deal with investment property. So what is the definition of investment property and how an owner-occupied property is different from an investment property? So remember that the owner-occupied property, we deal with this in IAS 16 under property, plan and equipment. But when it comes to investment property, we have to apply IAS 40. So as far as definition is concerned, investment property is property which might be a land or building or part of land or building or both, which is held by the owner or by the lessee under a finance lease. And what is the purpose? The purpose is to earn rentals or for capital appreciation or for both. It means any property that is land and building, which is either held by the owner or by the lessee under in finance lease. The purpose is, which is property that is being let out or held for increase in value, that is capital appreciation or both. Now, examples of investment property that comes in the definition of investment property. So first of one is land held for long-term capital appreciation. That is, you want to maximize the benefit of increase in value. Similarly, land held for currently undetermined future use. You don't know have future use, but you have land. So understood it is that it is being held for capital appreciation. And similarly, a building that is leased out under an operating lease. And a vacant building held to be leased out under an operating lease. Similarly, a property that is being constructed or developed for future use as an investment property. So property which is under construction and your intent to use it as an investment property for rental purpose or for capital appreciation purpose, you can classify this property as investment property. The following properties are not investment properties and therefore we will apply different accounting standard for those properties. For example, we have property held for use in the production or supply of goods and services or for admin purposes. So this is the property that is being used as an owner occupied property. Similarly, a property which is held for sale in the ordinary course of business or in the process of construction of development for such a sale, that is IAS 2 inventory is to be applicable. And property being constructed or developed on behalf of third parties that covers under IFRS 15 construction contract. And owner occupied property, including property held for future use as an owner-occupied property, property held for future development and subsequently used as owner-occupied property, property occupied by employees, and owner-occupied property awaiting disposal. Such properties are not classified as investment property. And property that is leased to another entity under a finance lease. But if property is leased out as an operating lease, that is classified as an investment property. Now, as far as the recognition criteria and measurement principles are concerned, so investment property should be recognized as an asset when it is probable that the future economic benefit will flow to the enterprise and cost of the property can be reliably measured. This is the same criteria which is being used in IAS 16 property plan and equipment and IAS 38 intangible asset. Now, what is the initial measurement criteria? Investment property is initially measured at cost, including the directly attributable cost, that is the transaction cost. So if you have purchased an investment property, the purchase price plus all other transactions cost and directly attributable cost is to be capitalized. What not to be capitalized is a startup cost, abnormal vestige, initial operating losses incurred before the investment property achieves the planned level of occupancy. So in all these costs are revenue expenditure, and these to be charged in profit and loss account. Once you have recognized property in balance sheet and initially measured at cost, then at each reporting date, the subsequent measurement criteria is IAS 40 allowed you to choose between a fair value model and a cost model. One method should be adopted for all of an entity's investment property, and changes is permitted only if this results in a more appropriate presentation. IAS 40 note this, that this is highly unlikely for a change from a fair value model to a cost model, as our intention is to earn capital appreciation. So it is beneficial to use the fair value model rather than the cost model. So if you use fair value model, so under fair value model, the investment property is remeasured at fair value at each balance sheet date. What is fair value? The price that would be received to sell an asset or paid to transfer a liability in an orderly transaction between market participants at the measurement date. And this is the fair value definition under IFRS 13. So for assets, the definition is the price that would be received to sell an asset. Obviously, if you measure at each reporting date at its fair value, there might be a change in fair value. So any change in fair value results in gain or loss from changes in fair value must be included in net profit and loss for the period in which it arises. So it is different from revaluation surplus, because we record revaluation surplus under OCI in case of owner-occupied property covered under IAS 16. But in case of investment property, gain or loss is to be recognized in profit and loss account. Fair value should reflect the actual market state and circumstances as of balance sheet date. And the best evidence of fair value is normally given by current prices on an active market for similar property in the same location and condition and subject to similar lease and other contracts. If you have any issues with fair value, then you can follow IFRS 13, the level 1 input, the level 2 input, and the level 3 input. If an entity is not able to identify the fair value of an investment property, then cost model is appropriate. So if an entity determines that the fair value of an investment property other than investment property under construction is not reliably determinable on a continuing basis, the entity shall measure that investment property using the cost model in IAS 16. And this is: the residual value of the investment property shall be assumed to be zero, and the entity shall apply IAS 16 until disposal of that investment property. So cost minus the depreciation. So under cost model, after initial recognition, investment property is accounted for in accordance with the cost model as set out in IAS 16, that is cost minus accumulated depreciation and accumulated impairment losses. So in case of investment property at fair value, there is no need for impairment, as already investment property is to be measured at fair value and changes are recognized in profit and loss account.